All right, the 49ers have pick number 13 and number 31. They picked up the 13th pick via the trade that sent DeForest Buckner to the Indianapolis Colts. Via ESPN, the 49ers have put out the word that they are open to trading either of those spots, number 13 or number 31. And look, this is part of the pre-draft process, too. I saw a tweet earlier today that Washington is receiving calls for the second overall pick in the draft, but they're not intent on moving it. Yeah, that's what happens the week of the draft. The teams with the highest picks receive calls from the teams that are lower just so that if something does potentially happen on draft night, there is some sort of foundation there that is in place so you have an idea of what the parameters would be, what the team is looking for hypothetically. Those conversations have to occur now or they become impossible to execute on Thursday night, Chris, especially while we're trying to do this stay-at-home draft that may or may not have some glitches or may or may not have some issues. So the 49ers have the two first-round picks. They've got nothing in round 2, 3, and 4. They would like to slide back, if they could, to pick up more lottery tickets in rounds 2, 3, and 4, where they have nothing this year.
Yeah, I think that's it's as simple as that. I mean, I think that Kyle Shanahan, John Lynch, the 49ers, they're just letting everybody know. You know, right now, hey, we're open for business. They have a very good football team, as we know. And I'm sure they want to add, like you're saying, more picks in the second, third round, more depth to their football team. You know, they got some guys that are getting older that they probably feel they got to fill the holes there for, too. So this is not surprising at all as far as what the 49ers are talking about. You know, trading these picks, they're not trading to move up. I don't think it's anything like that. I think it is all about, you know, trading down, accumulating picks. If you go down in the first round, there's a lot of talented football players to be had in the first 32 picks of this draft. And I think a lot of teams are looking at it going, okay, yeah, you know, we're here, but if we trade down 6 spots, we can get a similar guy with just a slightly less grade, just a few spots down. And while doing that, you know, we can get more draft picks in the process of all of this. So I think there's a lot of teams in business, just like we talked about with the Giants talking about that, Detroit. And I think that's the biggest reason I look at Thursday night. I'm excited for it because I think there could be a lot of trades and chaos, especially with this new technological format we got.
And when you have a quarterback that is making more than $25, $26 million a year, and his cap number this year is north of 26, and you've got a pass rusher in Dee Ford who's got a big cap number, and you're just 2 seasons away from being expected to pay Nick Bosa huge money, the more young, cheap guys you get, the better off you're going to be. You want guys that are coming in on that rookie wage scale, minimum salary, plus a signing bonus based on their slot. You get a lot of those guys, and you let them become the nucleus, then you can have that mix of some highly paid guys and some guys who aren't getting paid very much. And beyond Bosa and Jimmy Garoppolo and Dee Ford, the more successful the 49ers are, Chris, the more guys are going to want to get paid. The more guys are going to be in line to get paid. The more guys you're going to potentially lose to free agency. So you better have that pipeline of young guys. And the more picks you get, the more guys you potentially have to step up and replace free agents who inevitably will leave because you can't pay everyone.
No doubt about it. I mean, yeah, this, you know, hey, John Lynch, we know he's very smart. Kyle Shanahan, yes, he's my friend, but I mean, he lives this, you know that, and we've talked about it, you and I off air, and he's constantly thinking about how to build his team, the next move, 2 moves down the line. And also, you know, this is a guy that's very into the history of football and what's made teams successful and what has not. He struck up a relationship with Bill Belichick, we've heard, right, ever since the Jimmy Garoppolo trade. And I know, you know, I've had this conversation with Kyle. You know, yes, he's very aware that New England is New England because Bill Belichick was always willing to do the things you talked about, Mike. You know, low-level free agents, lots of draft picks, you know, not spending a ton of money or allotting a lot of the salary cap to just a very few amount of guys on your football team. You know, I think Kyle Shanahan is very aware of that aspect of trying to build a team that can sustain hot, you know, great level of play for a long, long time. And I would think this is a big part of Kyle's thinking process in this whole thing.
And you hear different names as it relates to the 49ers, like GM John Lynch, Parag Marate, the contractual mastermind. There is no doubt in league circles, though, that Kyle Shanahan runs the show there. He
right.
doesn't wear it on his sleeve. It hasn't been established as firmly as it is that Bill Belichick runs the show in New England. But make no mistake about it, Kyle Shanahan runs that show. And if he wants to trade down, if he wants to pull that trigger, that's what they're going to do.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I mean, he has full power. He's running the San Francisco 49ers organization. You know, now he's not like, you know, maybe the, I don't want to say, I don't mean this in a disrespectful way. I'm kind of just saying this for lack of a better way to say it. Maybe not quite the dictator Bill Belichick is in New England, right? But he's got a great way, Kyle, of communicating, delegating responsibilities, taking in what everybody has to say. But then ultimately, he's going to lean on his own football knowledge and his studies of what he thinks needs to be done for the football team. So, yes, Kyle, he's aggressive. We've seen that already in his first few years as a head coach. He's not afraid to make moves, whether it's for Dee Ford or Emmanuel Sanders or the trade for Jimmy Garoppolo. Hey, their first draft, they went from pick 2 to pick number 3. So I think, you know, between Kyle and John Lynch, a lot of football IQ there and guys that are not afraid to make some moves to be aggressive to help their football team.
He's got a different personality than Bill Belichick, which I think
yes,
keeps him from right. having that dictator persona. Plus, he doesn't have the pelts on the wall and or pellets on the horse, whichever phrase you prefer. Once you start winning Super Bowls as a head coach, that's when the aura around you changes. And who knows if that happens once Kyle Shanahan starts to amass Super Bowl trophies. One thing about the 49ers, though, if they do use those two picks, number 13 and 31, it will be the seventh time since 2000 that they have used two first-round draft picks. That's unbelievable.
Wow.
But they have six prior times during this century, this millennium, used two first-round picks. And I'll tell you what, they hit it big in 2007 with Patrick Willis and Joe Staley. Staley's
Ooh.
Still on the team, and they're expecting him to play at least one more year.
Wow, yeah. I mean, well, hey, listen, there's a reason that we saw that Jim Harbaugh, Trent Baalke team there in San Francisco be one of the most dominant football teams in the league for about a 2 or 3 year period. And one of the like all Adonis, one of the all off the bus teams. Like they were one of those teams, Mike, when I was working in New England in 2012 and pregame watching, you know, Patrick Willis, Navarro Bowman, Joe Staley, some of the other guys that you were like, whoa, this is one physical freak after another. So they must have killed it in the draft to build a team like that. But that's amazing to have that many multiple picks in the first round that many times so far this millennium.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.